to prepare myself. When we walk, we're going to come to the house again, tell you. That you, the only person that Jesus can covenant with, that the death angel will come tell you, say, no, prepare yourself, so that I will visit you. Change! Tell to somebody, say, we need to change!
And
even if you won't answer, you blow in their face. Tell them, say,
we need to change!
Wrapping the person up, laughing in him, showing teeth. Now the word of God is there to wash us and change us.
Amen.
Yes. Therefore, Jesus is passing by in 2:4 today.
Yes.
So those of us who know that we have found ourselves in those different, different kind of things,
yes,
things that will not help you tomorrow, let us leave it now.
Yes.
Because he's passing by. He's visiting. He's passing by. And you need your soul to be saved. Quickly, we need to change. We know how we are in this country. We know how we are. We can't finish from our mind. We can't finish from backbiting. And John said, it must too much. Let us change. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Somebody give your hand clap unto the Lord. Is for those who God is transforming our life today.
That's the second visitation. The second visitation.
Who God has seen their struggle. God, those who God has seen their tears. And he said that I'm passing by to you today.
Amen.
Those of us who have been victimized by so many people. Most of us will have been victimized. We trust people our lives. We so good to them. At the end of the day, they pay us evil for good. Most of us, our good can see good. But God is saying that God is restoring us today. There's a expectation for us today. There's a change for us today. The Bible says in the book of Luke, Luke chapter 1, from the 26th verse down to 38. Luke chapter 1. The Bible says that in the 6th month of Elizabeth, pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to a town in Galilee named Nazareth. He had a message for a young woman, promising marriage to a man named Joseph, who was a descendant of the King David. Her name was Mary. The angel came to her and said, peace be with you. The Lord is with you and has greatly blessed you.
Amen.
Mary was deeply troubled by the angel's message, and she wondered what this meant. The angel said to her, don't be afraid, Mary, for God has been gracious to you. You will become pregnant and give birth to a son in the name of Jesus. And he will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will make him a king as his ancestor David was. And he will be the king of the descendants of Jacob forever. His kingdom will have no end.
Amen.
Mary said to the angels, I am a virgin. How can this be? The angel answered, the Holy Spirit will come to you and God's power will rest upon you. For this reason, the holy child will be called the Son of God. Remember your relative Elizabeth. It is said that she cannot have children. But she herself is now 6 months pregnant, even though she's very old. For there is nothing that God cannot do. The other version says, for with God, nothing is impossible. He says, I'm the Lord's servant. Mary said, may it happen to me as you have said. And the angel left. Amen?
Amen.
The other version said, the King James Version, it said, with God, nothing is impossible.
Nothing
absolutely is impossible. Because we serve a big God.
Yeah.
That was a presentation from the angel. to Mary. And at that visitation, Mary began to boast in the Lord. She said that from today on, if you see from verse 46 to 49, quickly I want to read Mary's song. 46 said, Mary said, my heart praise the Lord. My soul is glad because of God my Savior, for he has remembered me, his Lord's servant. He said, from now on, all people call me one happy. All people call me one blessed.
Yes.
Because of the great things that the mighty God has done for me. May his holy name be praised. Amen?
Amen.
Mary said, from now on, all people call me blessed. When God presented Mary, there was a transformation in her life.
Amen.
Nobody called me present, you remain the same. No way. When he presents you, there has to be a change in your life.
Yes.
There has to be a change in your life. And some of us have been going through so many things. And God is saying to us today that he's passing by, he's visiting us.
Yes.
He told Zacchaeus, he said, no, today I'm going to your house.
Mm-hmm.
Our body is our house. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
So some of us today, Jesus is saying that he's passing by. He's visiting us today.
Amen.
And as he's visiting us, our life cannot be the same.
Amen.
As he's visiting us, those of us who have been troubled, those of us who have been lifeless, those of us who have been mocked, and those of us who people have said all kinds of evil things,
hey,
and nothing will come from us.
Hey.
Jesus is passing by our house today. We'll see how she'll manage. We'll see what happened to her now. At the end of her story. For who is meant to see or think it come to pass? When God and not command her to be so. Who is that man? To declare your end and stand when God has not put it up for months to the same thing. And he's still writing the same thing on the line. Until the day we can leave this place of this
life. Yes.
The story of our life continues.